Hi students, in today's section we are discussing about common emitter transistor characteristics. Okay, we know what is a common emitter transistor configuration. Okay, in the previous video we discussed about the common emitter configuration. Okay, just I would like to recall, if you take one NPN transistor, okay, we know transistor has three terminals. One is emitter, base, another one is collector. Okay, emitter moderate in size but it is heavily doped. Base is lightly doped and very thin in size. Collector is moderately doped but size is very huge. Okay, and in common emitter configuration, what we learn? Emitter is common for both input and output. So this is emitter now. Emitter is common for both input and output. Input is taken across the base and emitter, and output is taken across the collector and emitter, and emitter junction is grounded. Okay, we discussed about common emitter configurations and current gain in the common emitter configuration in the previous video. If you didn't watch, please watch that video. After that, if you coming to this common emitter transistor configuration, then only it is understood. Understand? So what is common emitter configuration? Emitter is common for both input and output, and emitter is earth. Input is taken between the base and emitter. Output is taken between the collector and emitter. Okay, this is called common emitter transistor configuration. Okay, now we are discussing about the characteristics. What is meant by characteristics? Characteristics is nothing but draw graph between the current and voltage. Okay, for a common emitter transistor, if you draw the graph between current and voltages, then it is called as transistor characteristics. Understand? Let us see the circuit diagram for the transistor characteristics. Okay, see, this is the circuit diagram for the transistor configuration, sorry, transistor characteristics. Okay, this is NPN transistor. We know in NPN transistor, the arrowhead always indicates the emitter. Okay, now I said previously, this is the common emitter transistor characteristics. That's why emitter is common for input and output. So this portion is taken as input and this portion is taken as output. Understand now? So now in input characteristics, we are giving the relation between the input current and input voltage. Okay, so here within this, input current is base now, that's why IB is the base current, and we know the base region is very thin, that's why we are taking a micro ammeter here. Okay, micro ammeter measures the current IB. Clear? Now B and E, in between base and emitter, we would like to measure the voltage. That's why we take one voltmeter here. That voltmeter name is given as VBE. Okay, voltage between base and emitter. Understand now? Now see here, this is one rheostat. Rheostat is nothing but variable resistor. So this is called a slider. If the slider moves along this resistor, okay, then whenever the rheostat slider is changes, VB changes and IB also changes. Understand? So to want to change the VBE and IB, you must be move the slider of the rheostat RH1. Is it clear? So this is about input. Let us see about the output. Output is taken across the this portion. Okay, here this is the output. Now output characteristics means it gives the relation between the output voltage and output current. Okay, so output current is what here? IC. IC is measured in milliammeter. IC is measured in milliammeter. So we are connecting 1 milliammeter here. Okay, and to measure the voltage across the collector and emitter, we are connecting a voltmeter here. Okay, so the voltmeter here denoted by VCE. Okay, voltage across the collector and emitter is denoted by the VCE. Understand now? Now, here again we are considering one rheostat. So if the slider of the rheostat is changes, then automatically VCE changes and corresponding IC value also change. Are you understand? So this is for input and it is for output. Clear now? Please concentrate on this transistor characteristics class, because most number of numericals in the transistor chapter is completely coming from the this transistor characteristics only. Okay, most of numericals came. If you neglected it, you didn't get any numericals. So please concentrate properly. Now this NPN transistor now required in proper biasing. Okay, if you make biasing, then only the transistor is in the active state. Otherwise, transistor is not working. So for biasing purpose, we are connecting 2 batteries here. One is for input, another one is for output. Okay, and we know the emitter junction is always in forward bias and the collector junction is always in reverse bias. Okay, so base emitter junction forward bias means P is connected to the positive terminal of battery. Okay, P is connected to far positive terminal of battery, then this base emitter junction is in the forward bias. So if it is positive, then it is always negative now, but it is giving earthing. Earthing means here the potential becomes 0 volt. Okay, so what is the voltage you given here? That is directly connected to the base. Clear? Next, collector junction is always in reverse bias. Now reverse bias means here N side of the N type of material is connected to the battery positive again, because it is in reverse bias. Understand now? So the negative terminal of battery again connected to the earth, means here the potential is 0 volt. So if I apply 5 volt or 10 volt, that is completely plus 5 volt only. Here also plus 10 volt. Okay, the negative terminal here I grounded, that's why this voltage is 0. Understand? Now let us see. This voltage is named as VBB. Okay, base source voltage. This is named as VCC, collector source voltage. So this is base source voltage, this is collector source voltage. These two are always required to activate the transistor, and VBB maintain base emitter junction in forward bias, VCC maintains collector emitter junction is in reverse biased. Understand? So this is the circuit arrangement for transistor characteristics. Are you understand? One more time. this portion related to the input, this portion related to the output. That is first you must remember. Okay, what is input characteristics? Input characteristics means by varying the potential, you can verify how the current is varies. Okay, so we require one voltmeter, one ammeter. Understand now? Here the voltmeter is connected between base and emitter. Hence, VBE measures voltage between base and emitter. And we know base is very thin region, lightly doped. That's why it is measured in the microammeter. Understand now? Next, for proper biasing, base emitter junction is always in forward bias. That's why P is connected to the positive terminal of battery. Okay, so this VBB called as base source voltage, which is always gives the proper biasing for the transistor. Understand? Coming to the output. In output, output characteristics indicates that graph between the voltage and corresponding variations in the current. To measure the voltage, here I give one voltmeter, which is connected between collector and emitter. That's why it is called as VCE. Okay, and collector current is very huge compared with the base current. That's why it is measured in milliammeter. This is milliammeter, here it is microammeter. Understand now? So for proper biasing of this one, we are connecting VCC, collector source voltage. Okay, so this output is always in reverse biased. Understand now? Now, by varying the sliders of rheostat RH1 and RH2, we can vary VBE and corresponding IB values, VCE corresponding IC values. Understand? Now, let us see the input characteristics and output characteristics. Okay, what is input characteristics? Input characteristics are nothing but if you draw a graph between the input voltage and input current. See here, this is input portion. In the input portion, input voltage is VBE. So take VBE along x-axis. VBE measures in volts and current IB is along y-axis, which is measured in microammeter. Understand? So VBE taken along x-axis and IB taken along y-axis. Understand? Now, while you explaining the input characteristics, always keep in mind within output VCE value always remains constant. Understand? So how can you make VCE remains constant? Slider of rheostat RH2 just move and place at certain value. For suppose I would like to take VCE value as 10 volt. Okay, so slider will be fixed at that place. RH2 is fixed at whenever you got the VCE value is 10 volt. Understand? So keep the VCE constant. Now vary the VBE value and verify the corresponding IB values. This is practically found. Okay, the graph will be coming like this. So at VCE value 10 volt, the graph will be coming in this way. Understand now? So from graph, what we observe? Properly check. See here, the VBE value increases from 0 to 0.2, 0.4 up to 0.6. IB value is 0 now. So there is no base current until VBE value reaches the 0.6. Okay, why? Because here the value of the VBE lesser than the barrier voltage. We know in between the base and the emitter there is a junction. At the junction there is one depletion layer. That depletion layer always has some barrier voltage, na? Okay, so if the VBE value lesser than the barrier voltage, there is no flow of current through the IB. Understand? So whenever the VBE value exceeds the barrier voltage, then current increases, and within the very short period the current increases rapidly. Understand? So before 0.6 there is no current. After 0.6 to very smaller value, current will be increases rapidly. Understand? And second one. Now, I would like to maintain VCE value as 15 volts. Again, the slider of RH2 will be adjusted until VCE value is 15 volt. Now, I would like to change the VBE and observe the corresponding values of IB. Then that graph will become like this. Okay, just observe properly. Here the threshold voltage value is little bit more, na? So if the VCE value increases, then what happens? It will be appears as increasing the value of VBE, na? VCE value increases to 15 volt, then VBE value is little bit increases, na? Okay, but it does not increases much more in the IB. Understand? So on varying the VCE, on increasing the VCE, appears in increasing the VBE value, but the effect of IB is negligible. That's why generally we are considering only one graph for input characteristics. Is it clear? Why? Because IB value is negligible. Clear? Now, for silicon transistor, VBE value is 0.6 to 0.7 volt. What does that mean? If you give more than 0.6 only, micrometer shows reading. Lesser than that, it is not possible. Understand? Next, the VCE values. VCE values in between 3 volt to the 20 volt. Okay, after doing number of practicals, they set these values. For silicon transistor, VBE value is 0.6 to 0.7 volt, and VCE value is ranges in between the 3 volt to 20 volt. You must be maintained. Understand? This is about input characteristics. One more time. Input characteristic is nothing but draw the graph between VBE and IB. At 10 volt of VCE, 10 volt of VCE, we got the graph in this way. From graph, we observe that VBE value before 0.6, there is no base current. That is the first point. Second point, exactly at 0.6, the current starts within the microammeter. Understand? So that voltage is called threshold voltage. Okay. After increasing that value from 0.6 to 0.8 within the small region, current increases rapidly. Understand? Second point, if the VCE value will be increases to another value between 20 volt, then what happens? VBE value increases. Okay, increase in VCE, which appears as increase in VBE. but it is not affected the IB values. That's why we are neglecting the all other readings. Clear? This is about input characteristics. Now, go through the output characteristics. Okay? The shape of the graph for output characteristics is like this. Now, let us see the output characteristics. Output characteristics nothing but in this region. In this region, voltage is VCE and current is IC. Okay, IC measured in milliamperes and VCE is measured in volts. So let us take VCE along x-axis, which is measured in volts, and IC is taken along y-axis, it is measured in milliammeter. Okay, so what is meant by output characteristics? Output characteristics is nothing but graph drawn between the output voltage and output current. Here output voltage is what? VCE. That's why it is, I am taking along the x-axis, and output current is IC. That's why I would like to take along the y-axis. Understand now? So VCE measures in volts, IC measures in milliammeter. Okay, milliamperes. Clear or not? Now, while we are changing the VCE value, and you may noted corresponding variations in the collector current within input, you must be keep IB remains constant. For taking output, IB remains constant here. How can you make IB remains constant here? By moving the slider RH2. Okay, if the slider of RH2 is adjust here until IB shows certain reading. See here, for IB 0 microampere, 10 microampere, 20 microampere and 30 microampere, practically observed this type of graph. Okay, from the graph, what is the points we observe? Please listen carefully. The first point, see, if the VCE value increases from 0 to 0.5, current IC increases rapidly. The voltage VCE changes from 0 to 0.5, current increases rapidly now. But after that, what happens? Listen carefully. If the VCE value exceeds the VBE. VCE value exceeds the VBE. Then we know this VCC in reverse bias. Whenever the output is in reverse bias, VCE value whenever more than the VBE, IC value is almost constant and it is linear with the VCE. Understand? If VCE greater than VBE, output is in reverse bias. That's why the current IC is almost constant, linear with the VCE. Understand? Now, IB value will be adjusted for 10 microampere. Again, until 0.5, current increases rapidly. After that, whenever VCE greater than VBE, current is again linear, constant. 20 microampere, again we got up to 0.5, current increases rapidly. After that, the current increases slowly and becomes constant. Clear now? So, in this way, we are observing the output characteristics. And please observe, if it is 10 microampere, IC is constant at 5 milliampere. At 20 microampere, it is at 7.5. At 30 microampere, it is at 10. Okay, so it indicates very clearly, if IB values increases, corresponding IC values also increases. IB value increases, corresponding IC values also increases. Okay, so IB and IC are increases in proportionate. Understand na? This is about the output characteristics. Clear? So for output characteristics, we may draw a graph between output voltage VCE, output current IC. Understand? While observing the output, input IB makes constant. Clear now? Now, varying the slider of RH2. Then VCE changes, IC changes. We got certain graphs for different values of IB. From graphs, what we understood? Before 0.5, current IC increases rapidly, but after that, if the VCE greater than the VBE, automatically what happens? The IC value increases slowly and it is constant. So IC is constant here for all values. And IC and IB are proportional to each other. Clear now? So this is input characteristics and this is output characteristics. Okay, here related to IB, IC values continuously varies. That's why we draw more number of graphs here. But here, if you increase the VCE, there is no variation in IB. That's why we draw only one graph. Clear? Please note it down. Now we are discussing the important parameters of transistor. For that, in input characteristics, we have RI. RI indicates the input resistance. Okay, if you want resistant, please use the formula of Ohm's law. We know the Ohm's law formula, V is equal to IR. Na? So from V is equal to IR, R is nothing but V by I. So V by I means here voltage in input characteristics VB. Na? So RI is indicated by delta VB by delta IB. What is RI? Input resistance. If you want input resistance, the change in base voltage by change in base current, which gives the input resistance. So what is change in VB and change in IC? It's very easy. Take, you need 2 points here. Okay, so this indicates variation IB, delta IB. Okay, and this is VB1, this is VB2. Okay, so this indicates the delta VB. Understand now? So we know the delta VB and we know the delta IB. So if you substitute delta VB and delta IB in this formula, you can get the formula of the value of the input resistance. Understand? Now see the output characteristics. In output characteristics, we have output resistance. If you want resistance, what is the formula? Change in voltage by change in current. Here change in voltage is delta VCE. By change in current means delta IC. Understand na? Now the value of R, I ranges from 1 ohm to the 5 kilo ohm. Okay, but R naught is ranges from 10 kilo ohm to the 50 kilo ohm. So R naught value is very, very huge compared to the RI, because input always maintained in forward bias, output is always maintained in reverse bias. Na? In reverse bias, resistance is more. That's why R naught value is always more compared with the RI. Understand? So one parameter is input resistance and another parameter is output resistance. And third one is current gain. In common emitter configuration, we know the current gain symbol is beta. And I said previously, gain means output with ratio with input. So output current here IC na. So this is delta IC by input current variation delta IB. Okay, at VCE is constant. At VCE constant, the ratio of the change in collector current to the change in base current is called as current gain. And in the previous section, we discussed about the values of beta. The beta values always lies in between 20 to 200. So beta ranges from 20 to 200. Is it clear? So these are the important parameters 1, 2 and 3. Clear? So please note it down about these parameters 1, 2 and 3. Okay? Here delta VB, delta IB maintained VCE constant na? Delta VC by delta IC by maintain IB constant. Understand? Note it down please. The last parameter is transconductance denoted by GM. In examinations, in recent examination, most times asking about the transconductance. We know the meaning of conductance. Conductance is nothing but reciprocal of resistance. Transconductance means in transistor, how the conductance varies. Okay, what is the formula for resistor? Resistor formula is V by I na. So conductance is nothing but reciprocal of resistance is nothing but I by V na. So the GM value consisting of I by V. So the transconductance is nothing but it is an electrical characteristic relating the current through the output of device, current through the output of device. In output, current is IC na. So delta IC by voltage across the input device. Voltage across input device means VBE na. Delta VBE. Okay. So what is the formula for transconductance? Transconductance formula is change in collector current to the change in base voltage, base emitter voltage. Clear? So it is one of the characteristic which always relating the current through the output of device to the voltage across input of device. Clear? Now the above equation is divided with IB, delta IB, both numerator and denominator. Okay, then what we got? Delta IC by delta IB nothing but beta na. And delta VBE by delta IB, delta VB by delta IB nothing but RI na. So transconductance has another formula. Okay, one is related to the delta IC and delta VBE. Another one is related to the current gain and input resistance. Is it clear? So this is the fourth parameter of the transistor. And the last one, we said in current gain, beta AC and beta DC values are nearly equal. In the previous section, we are discussing there. So in this part also, beta AC, which nothing but changes occurs, beta DC, direct formula IC by IB. If changes occurs, beta AC. If there is no change, beta DC. But beta AC and beta DC values are almost same. Is it clear? Since the IB values and IC values proportionately changes, that's why beta AC and beta DC values are nearly same. Understand? Thank you.